In this video, we will cover the required maintenance to keep your fuse sift running smoothly, your powder free of contamination, and your work area safe from airborne powder. For all maintenance procedures, Formlabs recommends wearing an N95 mask or better and wearing disposable gloves. The maintenance menu on your sift can be found by selecting the wrench at the lower left corner of the display. Here you will find steps to clean and replace the HEPA filter and how to clean and replace the sifter mesh. Unlike the fuse maintenance menu, these maintenance tasks do not have checkboxes. However, the sift does track the hours of use and will notify you if a maintenance task is approaching by displaying a small yellow or red circle by the wrench on the main screen. The other instructions in the maintenance menu, cleaning the fresh and reclaimed hoppers and tearing the fill scale, are only necessary in specific scenarios. Visit our support site for steps to complete these procedures when the time comes. Keeping powder from escaping from the sift vent hood and contaminating your workspace is very important. The best way to ensure this is keeping the HEPA filter in good working condition and able to draw the powder in. To clean the HEPA filter, first remove the tool shelf by lifting it up and off of the screws it rests on, and placing it in the work area of the sift. Then make sure the sift is not pulling air through the filter by turning off all other functions of the sift, including the light bar. Turn on the vacuum and using the flat end of the vacuum hose, move the vacuum across the surface of the filter in a top-down, top-down path. When finished, replace the tool shelf to its position in front of the filter. After 100 hours of use, the HEPA filter needs to be replaced. Start by moving the tool shelf aside and removing the 6 thumb screws from the frame around the filter. The 2 that hold up the tool shelf do not need to be removed. Lift the frame up off the rests and towards you, and place it nearby. Use thin pliers to pull the filter towards you by the metal mesh, taking care that any powder left in the filter may fall out. Dispose of the filter following local regulations. When installing the new filter, position it so that the arrow is pointing in the direction of the airflow and push it all the way into place. Replace the frame by placing it on the rests on either side and insert the thumb screws. Place the tool shelf back in its position, resting on the 2 thumb screws. Reusing nylon powder for future printing requires sifting to make sure that no contaminants are introduced to the fuse to obstruct motors, be fused into prints, or disturb the recoating process. This relies on the sieve, the mesh circle located below the surface grate in the work area of the sift. The surface grate keeps printed objects and tools from falling onto and damaging the sieve, and the sieve catches contaminants such as semi-sintered powder, smaller printed parts, hair, and brush wires. Cleaning the mesh every 20 sifted hours is required to keep it working properly and allowing powder to fall through. To do this, first vacuum out any powder and fused material from the work area above, the surface of the sieve, and around the edges. This is so when the sieve is removed, no contaminants inadvertently fall into the hopper. Next, pull each of the 8 turnbuckles up and turn them so they are no longer resting on the sieve. Remove the sieve and hold it over a trash can to catch any impacted powder or debris that is dislodged. Brush the surface of the sieve with a soft bristled brush until you can look through it and not see any obstructions. Place the sieve back over the hopper and, using a pair of pliers, lift and turn each turnbuckle back to its position over the sieve. The sieve will need to be replaced every 50 sifting hours. When loading powder into the fresh powder hopper, please be aware that there is no sieve here to catch contaminants before they are introduced into the powder supply. Before opening the fresh powder hopper lid, vacuum the area around the lid completely. Open the new jug of powder by removing the cap and exposing the foil on the mouth of the jug. Make sure to completely remove the foil from the mouth of the jug, as it can be easily ripped off by the powder and pulled down into the hopper. Once the foil is removed, open the fresh powder hopper lid and, in one quick motion, flip the bottle so that the mouth fits into the opening to limit any powder plume. Wait for the powder to empty from the jug and then quickly remove it from the hole and replace the lid. As for the vacuum, this Delfin Industrial Vacuum is a Class 2 Division 2 vacuum designed to safely handle powders such as the ones used in Fuse and Sift. To safely ground the vacuum, plug it into a properly grounded outlet and connect the grounding clamp to a conductive surface connected with the earth. The vacuum is also grounded when plugged into a properly grounded sift. When the bag inside the vacuum is filled, the gauge on the motor will cross over into the red, and the suction of the vacuum will be reduced. To change the bag, turn off the vacuum and unplug it from the sift or wall outlet. Pull up on each of the handled clamps to separate the motor from the body of the vacuum. Carefully place the motor on a flat surface. Looking inside the vacuum, remove the filter seated above the vacuum bag. Put this filter to the side. The opening of the vacuum bag houses zip ties that can be cinched before removal. This ensures that no powder will escape the vacuum bag when removing the vacuum bag from the vacuum. Once the bag has been removed, insert new zip ties into a new vacuum bag. Mount the opening of the vacuum bag onto the nozzle found inside the vacuum. Cinch the outermost zip tie around the nozzle to ensure that it is secured to the vacuum. Once secure, return the vacuum filter back to the vacuum. Replace the motor onto the body of the vacuum and reattach the clamps, pushing down on the handles fully to seal the vacuum chamber. Dispose of any filled vacuum bags in accordance with your local regulations. For more information or to order new bags, visit the website written on the side of your vacuum. You are now able to complete regular maintenance on your sift, which will keep it functioning at optimal levels.